Hey y'all, what's up? It's your girl Kitan here. I'm about to show you how to slay this blonde wig. Okay, look at it. So, if you're not already subscribed, please make sure you subscribe and check me out on my socials. Okay, now, this wig is from Premier Lace Wigs and it came like this. I didn't have to color it. Look at that ombre. And the only thing that I would say is that you have to customize and bleach the knots to make it look really natural. So, this is the box it came in and it also comes with a wig cap and elastic band. So, I'm about to show you how to bleach the knots. So, I have this shampoo here and this is the lightening powder. Some gloves, mixing bowl, developer, and a spatula thing with some foil. Okay, now let us begin. But make sure you don't buy cheap gloves because mine went to go and break. But I got a lot of gloves in one pack, so it's alright. So basically, I'm gonna grab the powder lightener and I'm just gonna put about one or two scoops into the mixing bowl. And this is just eyeballing it. And I'm pretty much just making sure that the lightening powder and the developer that I use are gonna make a toothpaste like consistency. That's really important. You want to make sure it's not too thick and not too thin. So yeah, I'm just mixing it right here and adding a little bit more powder because it was a little bit too thin. You know, just kind of like, you know, eyeball it and make sure you get it to the right consistency before you begin. Okay, so once you have it all, you know, ready, you just start putting it onto the frontal. So I later found out that this was a little bit too thick, but you know, it's okay, it worked out in the end. But yeah, so I'm just putting it all over the frontal and making sure I'm putting it on the front part. That's one of the most important parts so that it makes the front edges look natural. So I'm just covering it with the foil and, you know, just wrapping it. I'm just gonna leave it on there for about 25 to 30 minutes and you just have to keep checking it. See right here, I could see that it wasn't done yet, but when it was done, I just grabbed the neutralizing shampoo and I also grabbed the shimmering light shampoo and I just like washed it all off. And make sure you also co-wash it because I did that but I didn't show it, you know, in these parts. But yeah, now I'm just checking to make sure that everything is okay. You know, I had to put it on my own head to just make sure, but yeah, looking good. It's gonna get better, trust me. So now we have to customize the frontal. We have to pluck. So I had my sister come help me do this, and you know, basically you just have to make sure you're plucking and taking hair out of the front in a systematic manner. I've actually watched a lot of great videos on how to do this, so I'll leave the link down below because I don't really know how to explain how to do it. I just know you just have to make sure you're, you know, plucking. Now you're taking a long time. So I'm just showing you guys the process right here and all how much hair came out. Yeah, a lot of hair. Alright girl, we're about to make a little bald cap type thing with a wig cap. So basically you want to cut off this band right here. So I'm doing that right now with scissors. And then you're gonna have a kind of flimsy, you know, wig cap that doesn't have that band, but it's gonna be really good for your hair and really secure. So I grabbed the Gatsby glue and my sister, again, you know, she was real MVP because she really helped me out. And so basically you're just gonna, you know, put the glue on, let it dry a little bit, and then stick it and, you know, blow dry it as well. So you just do that. You continuously do that all around the head and it's just basically gonna create a new hairline for you, which is, you know, really safe for your edges because, you know, my edges are kind of struggling right now, so I just want to make sure I'm not, you know, putting lace on it. So yeah, I'm gonna grab a powder foundation and I'm just gonna put that all over the you know, where the line is. Grabbing this luscious wig and, you know, it's already started drying, so I'm already seeing how it's gonna look and I'm already loving it. I just wanted to quickly just check and make sure it's customized enough and just kind of pull it to where I think the hairline should be, and looking good. I'm just gonna, you know, brush the hair out because, you know, it's looking a bit rough, and then my sister helped me cut off the lace. So after you cut off the lace, then you start cutting baby hairs, and so we just wanted to make sure we had enough to kind of conceal the line that is kind of showing through the lace, if you can see that. And so after you get, you know, a good amount out, you then grab some Gatsby free spray, which honestly is one of the best inventions ever in life, and you just spray all around where you're gonna put the frontal of the wig on, and then blow dry it and start sticking it on. So once, you know, once it gets a little bit tacky, so you stick it on as precise as possible so that you put the lace onto where your false hairline is now with the wig cap, and you just keep going all around your head. I, you know, once again, you know, need a little bit of help, so my sister was right there to help me out. And then you just basically hold it on there just so that, you know, it stays very secure. And trust me, this lasts. This is like the third day now, and it's all good. It's good. So as you can see, it's already looking really good. The baby hairs are kind of coming out. It does look a little bit white on camera. I can see like it's a little white cast, but it's honestly not white. It looks great in person. And once I put the baby hairs, it will even start looking better. So it's fine. It's fine. But look at that, y'all. Look at me. Blonde. I can't even believe. So now we're grabbing some Eco Styler gel and just gonna, you know, put the baby hairs, you know, in this place where it's supposed to be so it doesn't move around. And yeah, guys, look, it's already starting to look good, and I'm really excited. You can see when I turn like in different angles that you can't even see that it's white, because I don't know what the lighting was doing. I don't appreciate it, but yeah. So here it is in its straight form. All I did was brush it out. I didn't straighten it at all yet. I wanted to add curls, so I didn't do that. But what do you think of this color? What do you think of the way it looks? It's blonde, so it's really versatile. You can dye it. You can do so much with it. And yeah, let me know what you think, if you like it straight or if you like it curly. Well, this is a bit wavy, but I just use my curling wand and I'm just, you know, adding a few little loose waves in there just to make it look just a little bit, you know, fuller and give it a different kind of look. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up if you liked it, and make sure you're subscribed if you're not already and click the notification bell. Anyway, thank you so much for watching. I'll see you in my next one. Bye.